Hello everyone, in this video, we'll learn how to add serial numbers while adding or deleting a row in a subform. The screen you're looking at now is the order form to collect customer orders. We have another form called line items. This form is being used as a subform in the order form. The subform field name is items. As this is a subform, customers can choose multiple products with varying quantities in an order. When you try to add or delete a row within the subform, you will notice that no serial numbers are displayed. It may be difficult for customers to know the count of items ordered. To address this requirement, we can create workflows to display serial numbers while adding a subform row and update the serial numbers while deleting a subform row. First, let's add a number field to the subform to display the serial numbers. Here, line items is used as a subform. So, we need to add the number field to the line items form. Go to the form builder. Let's add a number field and give it a name. Now, let's create a workflow to display the serial numbers whenever a new row is added. To do this, go to the editor and create a workflow to run on a form event. Choose the form on which we want to run the workflow. In our case, let's choose the order form. Choose the workflow to run when a record is created or edited. The workflow should be triggered when a row is added. Let's select this option as we want the workflow to be executed whenever a customer adds a new item to the subform. So, choose the items field, give a name, and proceed to create the workflow. Click on Add New Action. The deluge script builder will open. Let's define the logic here. To begin, declare a variable I equals 0. Next, use the for each record task to create a for loop to generate serial numbers for the newly added rows. Declare a variable and choose the item subform. Next, we must specify a value from which the loop should generate the serial numbers. To do that, type I equals I plus 1. Row dot, choose the field name on which the serial number should be displayed, equals I semicolon. We have now set the number value on the serial number field to increase by 1 each time a new row is added. Click Save. Let's check how this logic works on the subform. As you can see, when we add a new row to the subform, the serial numbers are getting generated accordingly. However, the serial numbers are not in order if we delete a row. To address this requirement, let's create another workflow to automatically reorder the serial numbers if a row is deleted. To do that, go to the editor and create a workflow to run on a form event. Select the order form. Choose the workflow to run when a record is created or edited. The workflow should be triggered when a row is deleted. We select this option as we want the workflow to be triggered when a customer deletes an item from the subform. So, choose the items field. Give a name and proceed to create the workflow. Click on Add New Action. Let's get started on the second script now. First, use the for each record task, declare a variable deletion and select the items subform. Then type new value equals deletion.sNumber minus 1 semicolon. Deletion.sNumber equals new value semicolon. In the third line of code, we subtract 1 from the serial number and save the result in the new value variable every time a row is deleted. In the fourth line, we replace the new value's value with the deletion variable. Next, let's use an if condition to see if the value of the serial number in the deletion variable is less than the serial numbers of the rows. To do that, use the if condition and type deletion.sNumber less than row.sNumber. Next, we must specify the action that must happen if the specified condition is met. In our case, we must add 1 to the new value variable and replace it with the serial number from the deletion variable. To do that, type new value equals new value plus 1 semicolon. Deletion.sNumber equals new value semicolon. Click Save. Let's see how this logic works on accessing the app. As you can see, when we add a new row to the subform, the serial numbers are getting generated accordingly. Similarly, when we delete a row, the serial numbers are rearranged automatically. That's all for this video. We hope you learned how to add serial numbers while adding or deleting rows in a subform. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about Zoho Creator and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video releases. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.